So the first thing that we're going to learn today is the long tail cast on. And the long tail cast on is created with two strands of yarn. You have a tail, which builds your stitches, and then you have the yarn coming from the ball. So to begin with, we're going to start with a slip knot. You're going to wrap the yarn around your index and middle finger, crossing in front, and from behind, you're going to slip the yarn into the circle and lift it off your fingers. So, and that is a slip knot. And the reason that it's called a slip knot is because if you pull it, it will undo itself. So again, take your index and middle finger, wrap the yarn around your fingers, crossing in front, and from behind, push the loop of yarn up the center of the circle and lift them off your fingers. Then you're going to take your knitting needle, and we're working with circular needles. You're going to slip the slip knot onto the knitting needle and tighten the slip knot. You're not choking the needle, you want it to slip off with ease. I'm just going to move the needles, the other end, out of the way, because I'm using a long needle, you're using a shorter needle right now. And I'm going to begin with the long tail cast on. So to begin with, you're going to take your thumb and your index finger and you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn. Then you're going to take your bottom three fingers and cup the two strands of yarn. You're not going to hold it so tight that the yarn won't flow through. You're going to take it so that the tail is on the left and the ball of yarn is on the right. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle the two strands of yarn, turn your hand towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger, and pull your knitting needle down in front of you. And what you have is a slingshot setup. And to begin the cast on, you're going to take the tip of your knitting needle and you're going to pick up the outside strand on your thumb, pick up the inside strand on your index finger. You're going to draw a line down your thumb, clear that outside strand, drop your thumb, drop that loop off your thumb, then take your thumb and pick up the strand of yarn again, swinging out to the left and pulling the needle down. You're going to keep your fingers on the stitches that you're making. I don't want you to be afraid to touch. So again, picking up the outside strand, the inside strand, draw a line down your thumb, clear the thumb and drop it, lift up and take your thumb and pull for a setup again for the next stitch. Outside, inside, down your thumb, drop the thumb and pull. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. So you're not a machine, so you have to sometimes reset yourself up. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle, turning towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger, and pull the knitting needle down for your setup. And pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and lift up and pull. That thumb comes around to pick up that strand of yarn to re-establish the setup so that you can make the next stitch. This is the long tail cast on. The tail is making the stitch, so your tail is going to get shorter. That's the outside strand on the thumb, the inside strand on your index finger. Draw a line down your thumb, clear it, lift, release, and pull for the new setup. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and lift and pull. And you can see that the tail is shorter because it's making these stitches. The stitches won't all sit on the knitting needle, they're going to fall to the cable. It's not going to affect the size of the loop. Outside, inside, down your thumb and pull. Take your thumb and your index finger in between the two strands of yarn turn towards you and pull the knitting needle down, pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb and pull. That is the long tail cast on. So you should have a short tail that you will use to weave in your ends at the end of your knitting. And there are your stitches. So the first thing that we're going to learn today is the long tail cast on. And the long tail cast on is created with two strands of yarn. You have a tail, which builds your stitches, and then you have the yarn coming from the ball. So to begin with, we're going to start with a slip knot. You're going to wrap the yarn around your index and middle finger, crossing in front, and from behind, you're going to slip the yarn into the circle and lift it off your fingers. So, and that is a slip knot. And the reason that it's called a slip knot is because if you pull it, it will undo itself. So again, take your index and middle finger, wrap the yarn around your fingers, crossing in front, and from behind, push the loop of yarn up the center of the circle and lift them off your fingers. Then you're going to take your knitting needle, and we're working with circular needles. You're going to slip the slip knot onto the knitting needle and tighten the slip knot. You're not choking the needle, you want it to slip off with ease. I'm just going to move the needles, the other end, out of the way, because I'm using a long needle, you're using a shorter needle right now. And I'm going to begin with the long tail cast on. So to begin with, you're going to take your thumb and your index finger and you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn. Then you're going to take your bottom three fingers and cup the two strands of yarn. You're not going to hold it so tight that the yarn won't flow through. You're going to take it so that the tail is on the left and the ball of yarn is on the right. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle the two strands of yarn, turn your hand towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger and pull your knitting needle down in front of you. And what you have is a slingshot setup. And to begin the cast on, you're going to take the tip of your knitting needle and you're going to pick up the outside strand on your thumb, pick up the inside strand on your index finger. You're going to draw a line down your thumb, clear that outside strand, drop your thumb, drop that loop off your thumb. Then take your thumb and pick up the strand of yarn again, swinging out to the left and pulling the needle down. You're going to keep your fingers on the stitches that you're making. I don't want you to be afraid to touch. So again, picking up the outside strand, the inside strand, draw a line down your thumb, clear the thumb and drop it, lift up and take your thumb and pull for a setup again for the next stitch. Outside, inside, down your thumb, drop the thumb and pull. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. So you're not a machine, so you have to sometimes reset yourself up. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle, turning towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger, and pull the knitting needle down for your setup. And pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and lift up and pull. That thumb comes around to pick up that strand of yarn to re-establish the setup so that you can make the next stitch. This is the long tail cast on. The tail is making the stitch, so your tail is going to get shorter. That's the outside strand on the thumb, the inside strand on your index finger. Draw a line down your thumb, clear it, lift, release, and pull to, for the new setup. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and lift and pull. And you can see that the tail is shorter because it's making these stitches. The stitches won't all sit on the knitting needle. They're going to fall to the cable. It's not going to affect the size of the loop. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. Take your thumb and your index finger in between the two strands of yarn, turn towards you, and pull the knitting needle down. Pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and pull. That is the long tail cast on. So you should have a short tail that you will use to weave in your ends at the end of your knitting. And there are your stitches. So the first thing that we're going to learn today is the long tail cast on. And the long tail cast on is created with two strands of yarn. You have a tail, which builds your stitches, and then you have the yarn coming from the ball. So to begin with, we're going to start with a slip knot. You're going to wrap the yarn around your index and middle finger, crossing in front, and from behind, you're going to slip the yarn into the circle and lift it off your fingers. So, and that is a slip knot. And the reason that it's called a slip knot is because if you pull it, it will undo itself. So again, take your index and middle finger, wrap the yarn around your fingers, crossing in front, and from behind, push the loop of yarn up the center of the circle and lift them off your fingers. Then you're going to take your knitting needle, and we're working with circular needles. You're going to slip the slip knot onto the knitting needle and tighten the slip knot. You're not choking the needle, you want it to slip off with ease. I'm just going to move the needles, the other end, out of the way because I'm using a long needle. You're using a shorter needle right now. And I'm going to begin with the long tail cast on. So to begin with, you're going to take your thumb and your index finger and you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn. Then you're going to take your bottom three fingers and cup the two strands of yarn. You're not going to hold it so tight that the yarn won't flow through. You're going to take it so that the tail is on the left and the ball of yarn is on the right. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, put it in between the two strands of yarn. Take your bottom three fingers and cradle the two strands of yarn. Turn your hand towards you. Open up your thumb and your index finger and pull your knitting needle down in front of you. And what you have is a slingshot setup. And to begin the cast on, you're going to take the tip of your knitting needle and you're going to pick up the outside strand on your thumb. Pick up the inside strand on your index finger. You're going to draw a line down your thumb. Clear that outside strand. Drop your thumb. Drop that loop off your thumb. Then take your thumb and pick up the strand of yarn again, swinging out to the left and pulling the needle down. You're going to keep your fingers on the stitches that you're making. I don't want you to be afraid to touch. So again, picking up the outside strand, the inside strand, draw a line down your thumb, clear the thumb and drop it, lift up and take your thumb and pull for a setup again for the next stitch. Outside, inside, down your thumb, drop the thumb and pull. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. So you're not a machine, so you have to sometimes reset yourself up. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle, turning towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger, and pull the knitting needle down for your setup. And pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and lift up and pull. That thumb comes around to pick up that strand of yarn to re-establish the setup so that you can make the next stitch. This is the long tail cast on. The tail is making the stitch, so your tail is going to get shorter. That's the outside strand on the thumb, the inside strand on your index finger. Draw a line down your thumb, clear it, lift, release, and pull for the new setup. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and lift and pull. And you can see that the tail is shorter because it's making these stitches. The stitches won't all sit on the knitting needle, they're going to fall to the cable. It's not going to affect the size of the loop. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. Take your thumb and your index finger in between the two strands of yarn, turn towards you, and pull the knitting needle down. Pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and pull. That is the long tail cast on. So you should have a short tail that you will use to weave in your ends at the end of your knitting. And there are your stitches. So the first thing that we're going to learn today is the long tail cast on. And the long tail cast on is created with two strands of yarn. You have a tail, which builds your stitches, and then you have the yarn coming from the ball. So to begin with, we're going to start with a slip knot. You're going to wrap the yarn around your index and middle finger, crossing in front, and from behind, you're going to slip the yarn into the circle and lift it off your fingers. So, and that is a slip knot. And the reason that it's called a slip knot is because if you pull it, it will undo itself. So again, take your index and middle finger, wrap the yarn around your fingers, crossing in front, and from behind, push the loop of yarn up the center of the circle and lift them off your fingers. Then you're going to take your knitting needle, and we're working with circular needles. You're going to slip the slip knot onto the knitting needle and tighten the slip knot. You're not choking the needle, you want it to slip off with ease. I'm just going to move the needles, the other end, out of the way because I'm using a long needle. You're using a shorter needle right now. And I'm going to begin with the long tail cast on. So to begin with, you're going to take your thumb and your index finger and you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn. Then you're going to take your bottom three fingers and cup the two strands of yarn. You're not going to hold it so tight that the yarn won't flow through. You're going to take it so that the tail is on the left and the ball of yarn is on the right. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, put it in between the two strands of yarn. Take your bottom three fingers and cradle the two strands of yarn. Turn your hand towards you. Open up your thumb and your index finger and pull your knitting needle down in front of you. And what you have is a slingshot setup. And to begin the cast on, you're going to take the tip of your knitting needle and you're going to pick up the outside strand on your thumb, pick up the inside strand on your index finger. You're going to draw a line down your thumb, clear that outside strand, drop your thumb, drop that loop off your thumb. Then take your thumb and pick up the strand of yarn again, swinging out to the left and pulling the needle down. You're going to keep your fingers on the stitches that you're making. I don't want you to be afraid to touch. So again, picking up the outside strand, the inside strand, draw a line down your thumb, clear the thumb and drop it, lift up and take your thumb and pull for a setup again for the next stitch. Outside, inside, down your thumb, drop the thumb and pull. Outside, inside, down your thumb and pull. So you're not a machine, so you have to sometimes reset yourself up. You're going to take your thumb and your index finger, you're going to put it in between the two strands of yarn, take your bottom three fingers and cradle, turning towards you, open up your thumb and your index finger and pull the knitting needle down for your setup. And pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and lift up and pull. That thumb comes around to pick up that strand of yarn to re-establish the setup so that you can make the next stitch. This is the long tail cast on. The tail is making the stitch, so your tail is going to get shorter. That's the outside strand on the thumb, the inside strand on your index finger. Draw a line down your thumb, clear it, lift, release, and pull for the new setup. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and lift and pull. And you can see that the tail is shorter because it's making these stitches. The stitches won't all sit on the knitting needle. They're going to fall to the cable. It's not going to affect the size of the loop. Outside, inside, down your thumb, and pull. Take your thumb and your index finger in between the two strands of yarn, turn towards you, and pull the knitting needle down. Pick up the outside strand, the inside strand, down your thumb, drop the thumb, and pull. That is the long tail cast on. So you should have a short tail that you will use to weave in your ends at the end of your knitting. And there are your stitches.